Hello, everyone. Tony Thorne with the American Fence Association. Today is Thursday, May the 21st, and this is Thursday's update. I hope everyone's staying safe and healthy. We do have some good information for you this week. Hopefully, this information we've been bringing over the last several weeks has been beneficial to your organization. As I reported last week, Homeland Security and cybersecurity had not given us any indication of changes. However, this week, May the 19th, we received the latest and greatest 3.1 revision of the guidance on the essential critical infrastructure workforce. Primarily, this has to do with the facility workers and at-risk communities, more so than any other changes. There wasn't any specific changes done to the trades industry or other categories that we're working on very diligently. As I mentioned previously, if you have any interest in serving on our governmental affairs program, which is going to stay right on top of this, please reach out to me and we'll get you plugged in pretty quick. I think this is probably two of the most important documents that we've put on the website in the last several weeks that we're going to load up this morning, and that is the Payroll Protection Program Forgiveness Overview and the Payroll Protection Program Application. So you went out and got your money. It told you what you need to spend it on. Now it's time in the next several weeks to be filling out the proper documentation to get forgiveness on that money to where you don't have to pay it back. So go to the website, review these two documents. There'll be three. There'll be that 3.1 update for the CISA, and then there will be the PPP Forgiveness Overview and the PPP Forgiveness Application. So again, make sure you go to the website and download those this morning. Real quick, I want to give you an update on the market. As we've talked about over the last several weeks, we as an industry, as a whole, we've got a huge demand on products and a diminished supply availability. So what's going to happen? I mean, we've talked about it. We're going to see prices increase across the board. It's just inevitable. That's the demand and supply chain. It's nothing that we can do about it as an industry. It's something that we have to work with and deal with. And again, I've shared with you numerous times, have a good open conversation with your supply, your wholesaler distribution sites to know what's going on and how it's affecting you. Several of you told me how busy you were and how much workload you had. And a lot of you said, man, I'm out buying new trucks, new equipment. I'm putting workforce in place. I'm paying X amount per hour to get these guys on board, which you've paid more for inexperienced labor than you've ever have in your life. And now all I'm saying to you is be cautious and be very, very safe in knowing what's occurring with this pandemic, because this is going to slow down. And when it slows down, you're still going to have that payment on that truck. You're still going to have that employee. You're still going to have that equipment. And you need to be able to position yourself for that slowdown, which, again, is inevitable. And you need to be positioned for that when it occurs. So don't say I didn't say I told you so, but just be careful and watch what you're doing there. And I'm sure that you will run a very effective and efficient business. So a few things on the market, the ag industry. As I mentioned last week, we're seeing an above average sales and demand on products with a depleted supply. The highest demand is coming from the lighter, less expensive products such as a 4x2 14-gauge welded wire and poultry netting and hardware cloth. The second thing that was hit, which I mentioned last week, was the round treated post for the agricultural market. And that was due to the wet spring and the harvest not being able to be done, and it wasn't being able to get to the mills, cut, dried, and then treated. So knowing that these issues are there, knowing what you can expect on transportation delays, that's important for you from the agricultural market. Again, knowing what's going on, having good conversations with your suppliers. As a wholesale market, the reports I'm getting from our major suppliers is that not as much change from last week. A lot of them are seeing smaller orders that just gets those contractors through the week. We're not seeing a lot of inventory orders, and I think that that's just due to the uncertainty of what's next. Yeah, we've got a lot of businesses opening up. We've got a lot of states opening up, but still there's that uncertain factor that just kind of plagues us to get back to some level of normalcy. So hopefully we'll see that in the next few weeks and have a better report on it. The chain link and pipe, as I mentioned, the availability was there due to the ramp up for the summer months, and then COVID hit. So typically that product is available. Unfortunately, we do have transportation delays. So know what those transportation delays are going to do for you and how it's going to affect your business. The wood market, again, as I mentioned last week, we're seeing a huge demand with limited supply. And as I mentioned last week, that many people are returning to work this week. Therefore, that's going to take the DIYers off the market, so to speak, allow you, the professional fence industry guys, to get back out there. But what that's going to do for us is that's not going to, the big box movers are not going to be taking our supply. And whereas the suppliers now can go to our fence wholesalers and professional wholesalers and distribution sites to be able to get you the product that you need in probably a more timely manner. Again, understanding what your transportation delays are going to be. The vinyl and ornamental market, vinyl hasn't seen a whole lot of change. It's kind of been steady throughout this whole COVID issue. Again, I mentioned pockets all over the country, more stronger than others. The availability to move product, again, with transportation delays was always there. The ornamental market, however, had that holdback due to supply of steel, in the early months, but then they had also ramped up their inventory for the summer months as well. So most manufacturers of ornamental and aluminum products had availability, but I am hearing stories that there's 3 to 4 week delay on some products, not all, but again, understanding what your transportation delays are and being aware of those. Mentioned to you as an industry, it is what it is. And we just have to act professional. We need to have good communications with our manufacturers, suppliers, and wholesalers and distributors to know what's going on and better position ourselves. I think that each and every one of you have been doing a great job in monitoring yourself from the budgeting and forecasting perspective that we mentioned early in the game. And a lot of you have been taking advantage of some of the webinars we've been doing on the AFA site the last several weeks. We're producing two webinars a week, typically on Tuesday and Thursday at 2 p.m. Central Time. These have been well attended. Last week, we had some of our highest numbers on the UL and ASTM introduction and UL and ASTM checklist. And all of these webinars are available to you as a member behind the member sign-in portal on the AFA website. Any of you non-members, we want you to get this information. We just ask you to reach out to us at memberservices@AmericanFenceAssociation.com, and we will be more than happy to provide you with this content. We just like the opportunity to talk to you about being a member. I mentioned in my first week that there's no better time to be part of an association because an association like AFA can provide the voice, and we need the numbers to be able to make the difference when it comes to working with Homeland Security and cybersecurity and other agencies through our governmental affairs program. So we hope that you'll get on board and help us because we want to help you, and we're all in this together. So just remember about those webinars and remember about those training sessions. We do think that they'll be very valuable to you. And as I've kind of used as my motto through this whole thing over the last several weeks, stay safe, stay healthy, stay motivated, and continue being that leader. And as always, if you need me, please reach out to me on my cell, 972-533-3658, or tony@AmericanFenceAssociation.com. Thank you for all the emails. Thank you all for all the positive feedback that we as an association have been providing you the information you needed to make good, educated decisions to run your business effective and efficient. And we just wish you continued success. And God bless everybody. And y'all have a great week. Thank you.